Now we're ready to assemble the proteins themselves through a process called translation. So the flow of genetic information is we start out with deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA, and through transcription then we get ribonucleic acid, in this case messenger RNA. From that then we're going to go to proteins from the process of translation. Now proteins do all kinds of things in our bodies. Those are the enzymes that are involved often with the replication and the transcription itself that we've seen so far. Also enzymes that we digest our food with, enzymes that do all kinds of things in our bodies. We have molecular defenses against infection that is produced by our immune system. Those are called antibodies. There are other things that are important to our health called globins. These are all proteins. So are the hormones that make men men and women women. Muscle tissue, fiber, just about everything you see in a body is made up of protein. So this is where we're going to have the different traits that are really important in evolutionary process and, of course, in our daily lives. So in translation, we're going to go from RNA, which is a long chain of nucleic acids, just like the DNA. And from that, we're going to go to proteins. But proteins are made up of very different building blocks. And RNA and protein are so different in structure that RNA must be translated to protein. So we have our four nitrogenous bases of RNA. Those are the only letters in the words that are available to the RNA. So C, G, A, and U, or guac. A protein, though, consists of up to 20 different amino acids. So all these different amino acids are linked together in various combinations to produce these incredibly different structures of hormones and antibodies and muscle, etc. Now, how do we do that? It turns out that there is a genetic code which consists of a triplet of nucleotides that codes for a specific amino acid. So here's a table of the genetic code. And so we're going to look at nucleotides in threes, in trios, in triplets. So there'll be the first position, the second position, and the third position. And the only letters available in the RNA are U, C, A, and G, U, C, A, and G, U, C, A, and G. Okay? Now each triplet in the world of genetics is known as a codon because it codes for a specific amino acid. So if we have a coding region along the messenger RNA that says U, so it's uracil in the first position, uracil in the second position, and guanine in the third, so U, U, and G, that will only result in a leucine, that's an amino acid called leucine, to be put in place in the growing chain of a protein. Okay? If we then have G, A, G, so that's this place on the table, then that only codes for glutamine. So if we had UUG, that would first put down a leucine in the chain of amino acids. And if we then went on to GAG, that would only put glutamine. So we'd have leucine and glutamine in order on our growing protein chain. So what we're going to do is we have messenger RNA, and this is key for providing the blueprints for the proteins, those different amino acids, their sequence. And there are now two new RNA molecules that are both important for this process of going from the long nucleotide chains to the amino acid chains of protein. And these are tRNA, which is transfer RNA, and rRNA, which is ribosomal RNA. So tRNA is the transfer RNA. That's the actually translator. So it's going to be attached at one end to an amino acid, and at the other end, it goes in and looks at the codon on the messenger RNA. So that delivers the right amino acid to the right spot on the chain. So it's the translator that moves amino acids into place for protein assembly, transfer RNA. The second one is ribosomal RNA, and that's actually like a glove, as we'll see in some of these videos coming up. It's a glove that holds everything in place, and this controls what comes in as we have the growing sequence. This is also made up of a long chain of nucleotides, and this is ribosomal RNA. So here we go. And again, there's going to be a lot of details in here. The key thing I want you to get are the messenger RNA being translated with the transfer RNA and the ribosomal RNA. So those three players, that's the bit we want to see.
In addition to producing mRNA, the cell produces two other types of RNA, transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA. mRNA, tRNA, and rRNA all play a crucial role in protein synthesis. Proteins are long chains of amino acids. There are 20 common kinds of amino acids, represented here by different colors. Each type of amino acid has a similar chemical structure, except for a variable part known as the R group. Within a protein, amino acids are linked to each other by a peptide bond. The sequence of amino acids in a protein is coded in the sequence of bases in DNA. Therefore, translation, or protein synthesis, begins with the transcription of DNA into messenger RNA, or mRNA for short. The linear sequence of bases in mRNA is then translated into the linear sequence of amino acids in a protein. Each amino acid is specified by a group of three bases on the mRNA. This group of three bases is called a codon. In addition to mRNA, several other components are crucial for protein synthesis. Twisted strands of RNA, called transfer RNA or tRNA, match amino acids to their corresponding bases on the mRNA. The three bases on the tRNA, called the anticodon, hydrogen bond to their complementary codon on the mRNA.
So here we have the transfer RNA. I say this is the translator because it has a sequence here. It's looking for the codon on the messenger RNA. And this one that has UAC here, it only delivers a certain kind of amino acid.
The anticodon on the tRNA also specified which amino acid was bound to its 3' end. Enzymes called aminoacyl synthetases bind the COOH end of the amino acid to the 3' OH of the tRNA. Protein synthesis occurs on ribosomes that are composed of a small subunit and a large subunit. These subunits are made of ribosomal RNA and several proteins. Translation of mRNA into protein occurs in three stages: initiation, elongation, and termination. Formation of the initiation complex begins when the small ribosomal subunit recognizes and binds to a sequence of bases in the leader sequence on the mRNA. At the same time, the first tRNA bearing an amino acid matches its anticodon with the start codon, AUG. The large ribosomal subunit joins the small ribosomal subunit, mRNA, and the first tRNA to complete the initiation complex. The first tRNA fits snugly into the P site of the complex. The A site is empty. Elongation begins when a second tRNA with its attached amino acid approaches. The tRNA matches its anticodon with the second codon of the mRNA and settles into the A site. The first amino acid is transferred from its tRNA to the second amino acid by another enzyme. A peptide bond forms between the two amino acids. The joined amino acids form a dipeptide that is now attached to the second tRNA. The first tRNA leaves the P site. The ribosome moves down the mRNA to a third codon. The tRNA bearing the dipeptide now occupies the P site. The empty A site is ready for a new tRNA bearing an amino acid. The third codon is recognized by the anticodon of a third tRNA carrying an amino acid.
So again, what I really want you to focus on, we have our messenger RNA, and it's being translated one codon at a time by the transfer RNA, each delivering an amino acid. These then bind together to form a chain. So when they're short, they're called dipeptides, polypeptides. As they grow, then we recognize them as proteins. The ribosomal RNA is the kind of physical structure that holds everything in place so that this sequence can be very carefully followed.
The dipeptide is now transferred to the third amino acid, freeing the second tRNA. Because more than two amino acids are now linked by peptide bonds, the growing chain is called a polypeptide. The process of adding amino acids is repeated many times during translation as the ribosome moves toward the 3' end of the mRNA. Translation is terminated when the ribosome encounters one of three stop codons at the end of the gene. The stop codon shown here is UGA. A release factor recognizes the stop codon and settles into the A site. An enzyme releases the polypeptide chain from its tRNA by adding a water molecule. This frees the polypeptide chain, the last tRNA, and the release factor. The two ribosomal subunits dissociate from the mRNA and are free to form another initiation complex. Although we've shown only a single ribosome binding to a strand of mRNA, many ribosomes actually bind to an mRNA. A polypeptide is produced at each ribosome. In this way, several identical polypeptides are produced at the same time.
So here we have our messenger RNA, and it's being translated multiple times so that we're getting a lot of proteins off of this one template, off this one set of instructions. Here is an actual photograph of the process of transcription and translation in bacteria. So these bits and bobs over here are along this template segment of DNA. And so we're first getting the transcription into messenger RNA along the DNA molecule, and then we're getting translation as the ribosomes attach to the messenger RNA, and then proteins are being built. So here we're synthesizing lots of different protein molecules from this single strand of messenger RNA. So this is how we get enough material from these tiny minute amounts of DNA to grow great big bodies. So let's go back to the DNA, and we have a long chromosome with maybe millions of nitrogenous bases in the language of Gattaca, 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 and there's only going to be one stretch that's going to be transcribed. Let's say it's 5,000 base pairs long. At the end of transcription, there'll be a long strand of pre-messenger RNA that's also 5,000 base pair long, but instead of being Gattaca, it's now guac. This is then processed, removing those introns, those non-coding regions, and this may only leave about 900 base pairs. Now this is the messenger RNA that's going to be the template in turn for protein synthesis. And since there's 900 of these, three each per codon, this is going to lead to a protein that may be 300 amino acids long. So we go from DNA to RNA to a polypeptide. We have our double-stranded DNA molecule. We have the synth strand, it's called, and the template strand. We're going to be transcribing the template strand, and we're going to have then the complementary partners going from Gattaca to guac, G with C, U with A with T, etc. So here we have our messenger transcript. And these are now going to be read in translation according to these codons, every three nucleotides along the chain. And so here we have now the transfer RNA with their anticodons, they're called. They're going in, looking, I'm CAA, oh, you're GUU. You fit, okay? And then UCG likewise looks for AGC, And AGC looks for UCG, okay? Each delivering their own specific amino acid. So in this case, this template of DNA ultimately codes for these three amino acids in the polypeptide, valine, serine, and serine.